For this reflective documentary, I decided to use a phrase to describe my fall and winter this year because I don't think one word could sum it up. But maybe a sentence would get closer to how it really was. So I chose, "There is no need to have it all, just make the most of what you have," because that is what we have tried to do all this year. We were gifted this year and the rest of the year to come. Some of it is in front of me and some of it behind me. And I really have tried to make the most of it, become the leader I wanted to be, become the person I valued to be, and set up for the person I strive to be. This year we were given many opportunities and we tried to make the most of them. Most people know of our Thanksgiving celebration, but this year was a little hard. We were set back a week and had many kids absent. But we brought the Christmas cheer and tried to enjoy it the best we could. Our classes have been limited to 3 times a week, but with that we also got the great opportunity to work with GLLT. We have worked with this opportunity that was presented to us, and even when the class schedule is hard, we try our best. Mesa has been different this year compared to last year, even only being halfway through the year. We have so many more opportunities this year than last, even if we don't have it all. Compared to my 6th grade year, Mesa is even more different than last, but we are working with what we are given and making the most of it. For example, Bryant Pond. We weren't able to stay over like previous years, instead we went for 3 days in a row, fitting in as many traditional activities as we could, and trying to make everything like it once was. To conclude, do you really need everything, or can you make the most of what you have, sucking every gifted moment out of it, making it the most it can be? That is what we have tried to do this fall and winter. This is what we are going to continue to do.
Mesa is like a garden. We are a community full of people who grow and change together. I joined Mesa last year not knowing anything about it. But as I grew closer to the program and the wonderful people in it, I realized that Mesa is a big family. If I were to sum up this year with one word, it would probably be progress. To say the least, this year has been very difficult and stressful. COVID brought upon a lot of pressure and change.
Do you feel safe, Mona?
She doesn't feel safe!
It was as if I had the past year planned out on paper, and COVID erased it all, making me start from scratch. My 3 teachers have been so helpful though, always there to make me smile on a bad day, and they've managed the program through the setbacks we have suffered due to the pandemic. That's why Mesa is a home, where we'll always feel safe, accepted, and understood. Although every home built from sticks and stone can break and fall apart, Mesa has held together, a shelter of people who care about each other and the program, despite the cracks COVID has created. I feel so supported here. If I'm ever going through something, I know I have so many people who are there for me. I can thank Mesa for a lot of the progress I've made, school-wise and personally. I've made progress within school. For example, I'm becoming a better writer and I am understanding math class more. I love the virus unit that we are doing in science class right now. I like to think that I've also been doing better on our EXP trips. I've been a lot more prepared this year than last year. Overall, I've been more focused on the trips too. We all have our off days where we're not in the right space for anything school related, but I've been better focused and involved this year. I've always worried about everything. School, homework, friendships, you name it. But as Robert Downey Jr. puts it, worrying is like praying for something you don't want to happen. Mesa helped my anxiety about fitting in, friendships, and schoolwork. Although nothing can stop me from being nervous about things and worrying about practically every assignment due date, Mesa has definitely lowered my stress level. For most of my life, making new friends has been hard for me. I've stuck to the same friend group for years. Those friends hold a special place in my heart, but when I joined Mesa, I was able to make new friends. I want to say thank you to Mila, Ollie, and Maddie, three of my newest friends this year. So simple to smile and wave at a stranger or grin and laugh at someone's joke, but did you know that it takes at least 10 to 20 muscles to smile? This reminds me of our emotions. We're not always okay, even though it may seem like that. I've made progress in my 7th grade year so far, with friendships, family, and accepting others and myself. That's why if I were to describe my year so far in one word, it would be progress.
If I were to sum up my fall in one word, it would be revivified. Revivified means to give new life or vigor to. That describes how the beginning of my year felt, particularly after last year. Between the things that returned, new things, the cumulative excitement for everyone, and how that excitement affected our group dynamics, coming back to school felt like coming back revivified. By the end of the fall, we had already gone on more trips than we did all of last year. That was exciting because it reminded me of 6th grade, which I have such good memories of. This likely also had to do with our much more defined and vigorous schedule as opposed to 7th grade. Meeting with Tin Mountain and the Greater Level Land Trust each week went well and was definitely good for EXP groups as they got to know each other. An important part of my development in 6th grade that we regained this year was having full groups, which I think are an important part of Mesa. When we weren't on trips, but on a Monday, Tuesday, or Wednesday, moving for classes and mixing grades made Mesa seem much more like it's supposed to. All of these things contributed to the invigorating experience of this fall. But enough comparing to last year. This year was exciting for other reasons too. Coming into 8th grade was something that I didn't really even comprehend until pretty far into the year. When I was in 6th grade, it seemed so far away. I guess it really wasn't. Being a leader in Mesa and in my EXP group was something I'm not sure if I was ready for. But it's gone pretty well. Besides new tasks of my own, I think that all of Mesa was excited for a chance to do other Mesa things. Like Ben, which the 7th graders have never done. And maybe an in-person speech night, which would be new for all of us, as well as for brand new things, like our Thursday and Friday consecutive EXP trip days. All of these things, I feel, helped to build a lively and invigorating atmosphere. 8th graders were excited to get back to Mesa, 7th graders were excited to experience regular Mesa, and 6th graders were glad to get out of mainstream. Plus, everyone felt like the coronavirus was going away. It wasn't, but that definitely helped build excitement. Having constant excitement and anticipation like I've been describing is something that I've learned is very important as a Mesa student. Being in an environment where you are forced to completely motivate yourself in order to progress is something very unique to programs like Mesa. As Mr. Oliver said, middle school is the last time that someone would be paid to like you. I think that one reason that Mesa students tend to be more prepared for high school is because they've gotten a jump on that. Being in circumstances that require you to think for yourself, voice your opinions, and take leadership roles will benefit you the rest of your life. I think that the revivifying atmosphere has been a big part of why this year has been good, because it has motivated everyone. I'm sure everyone agrees we've had a pretty great year. I think it can only get even better.
If I were to sum up my year in one word, it would be healing. This past year, we are slowly making our way back to normal, slowly healing the past and preparing for the future. Last year, I joined Mesa and had no idea what I was in for. Mesa is different from any other thing I have ever done or been a part of. You are so appreciated and cared for in Mesa. We all have each other's backs, and that is what makes it so special, something I'll never forget and will always value. A difference this year is that we have EXP groups, which presents an amazing opportunity to collaborate with others and share your notes. I lucked out with my AXP group, getting the most amazing and supportive group possible. We work very well together and get a lot done. We also have a good time, which I think is very important when learning. You learn better when you're with kind and caring people who care for you and you are happy and eager to learn. This past year, we have started to work with Greater Level Land Trust, which I personally love because it presents so many new opportunities for learning. Lee has taught us so many new things and given us many different perspectives on the forest. For example, when we visited the Level Box Company, we were able to see a different view of the forest from a logger's perspective. While when we went on a trip with Shane Dugan, being a forester, we saw a totally different side of things. There have also been many goods this year, but of course, there also have been bads. And yes, this year is very stressful and challenging for everyone, and COVID has brought a huge burden on all of us. But it's like a dandelion growing from a crack in the sidewalk. The sidewalk being the world, the crack being all the setbacks and challenges, and the dandelion being the new hope or medicine. For example, maybe the dandelion was the vaccine this year to make sure people could stay safe and healthy. It depends on how you think about it. If you don't like something, change it. If you can't change it, change the way you think about it, said Mary Angel Britt. This is a quote I just happened to stumble on one day, and now I live by it. It's true, you can't change others, you can only control yourself. That is also very important to think about while being in middle school, because you do get in arguments and fights, but you can only control what you do and say, so why not treat others how you want to be treated? So yes, this year was hard, but what I'm trying to say is that to get to the rainbow, you gotta put up with the rain, said Dolly Parton. My dreams, they fall and form a bridge of memories where I can give back. All of my dreams, they fall and form a bridge of memories.
One way to describe the start of my 8th grade year would be to say that there was a constant ticking. The ticking of a clock always in the background, sometimes very obvious and loud, while other times barely noticeable. The times when it was loud and prominent were when I was stressed over schoolwork or realizing the glaring obviousness that next year I will be at the academy. That's when I noticed the ticking sound of time slipping away from me. I don't think anyone ever feels like they have enough time to do everything they want to, it's just not possible. However, when I looked through the footage from our year, I realized that every photo and video captured a moment where the ticking was the last thing I was thinking of. The photos captured moments of fascination and pure happiness that I was there. Even videos of me frantically taking down notes had happy memories because those notes uncovered deep secrets of the world around me that I hadn't noticed before. Secrets that weren't really secrets, but merely the cogs of the world that keep everything together. The way the trees communicate, how the sheer height of a mountain alone molds and shapes the plants and animals on the very top. The footage captures moments where the ticking stops altogether because memories are frozen in time and knowledge lasts almost forever. So although I may be running out of time here in Mesa, the wonderful home of my learning, every single tick of the clock creates memories that will stay with me for a life.
If I were to sum up my fall in one word, it would be straining. I was thinking of taking the part in my reflective documentary from last year that said I didn't like doing this, but I thought I'd say it again. I did not like the process of making my reflective documentary at all. I would say my year has been straining this fall for three reasons: Mandarin, my speech, and the time I've missed. For a start, Mandarin has been really straining for me because I got a 1 in the first semester and I only have 1 to 2 days of Mandarin class a week. Secondly, I think this year has been straining because of my speech and all the stresses that come along with it. such as having to write one that you feel strongly about. It took me until February to find my topic, let alone write the whole thing. Looking back at my sixth grade year, I was in a similar situation. I was having trouble memorizing my speech, but it turned out great, like I hope this year's speech will. Lastly, the time I've missed. This year, I was out for 22 days because of COVID-19. One of the times, Rhett got sick, and we thought I was sick too with COVID, but I wasn't. The straining part about this is what I had to catch up with. Most of the catch-up was Mandarin. I had 3 weeks to do 6 tests. That's why I got the 1. Thank you for listening.
I would describe my fall in Mesa as encouraging. Whether that be in a group setting, in a class setting, or with your friends, this year has been overwhelmingly encouraging. Mesa is an environment to give your all in what you do and grow as a person. As an 8th grader, I love being able to see the 6th and 7th graders open up. Whether that be more comfortable talking and asking questions or giving a song suggestion on the bus, it's so exciting to see them open up. After being in Mesa for 3 years, it feels like you have a second home, and that's what I love about it. It's the relationships and memories you have that make Mesa so great. Like a lot of kids, I was in Girl Scouts growing up, and one of their sayings was to leave a place better than you found it. That's my biggest goal to do by the end of my time in Mesa. A lot of people ask, how are you doing, to be polite. But in Mesa, people ask that to see how you're doing and to see how they can help. Whether you're in a circle with Lee or Mike or you're just sitting in class, people will always care.
Mr. Oliver's reflective documentary hit home for me. It made me feel a little guilty because I have sent an email or two that may have added to his stress. It is often easy to see the bad, but never acknowledge the good. Even experiencing it in my own line of work and knowing I feel the same didn't make me think twice before typing away. So after my kids were asked to create a reflective documentary, I thought I'd do the same. I'm not tech savvy, so this is my attempt. I'm a third-year Mesa parent, and the word that comes to mind when I think of the past 3 years is indebted. Indebted for the experiences I wish I would have had when I was in 6th, 7th, and 8th grade. I'm indebted to the 6-plus instructors. Yes, 6 by name. Mrs. Barry, Mrs. Louie, Mr. Oliver, Mrs. Schoenfeld, Mike, Lee, and then the so many others that have been brought in to give my kids an amazing educational experience. I'm indebted to the district for supporting such a program. I am amazed with the sometimes 2 times a week videos that show learning like learning should be. I am in awe of the friendships and bonds that have been created among students. I am indebted to the other parents that have raised fine young adults that don't judge, but accept and connect with my kids. I hope that all of you instructors realize that the stress you have felt this year is truly appreciated, because the results of your hard work and dedication are shown daily in the zest for learning you have instilled. I am very grateful that I have the rest of this year and 1 more year to be a Mesa parent. But all in all, I think that after having a kid in Mesa, you are forever a Mesa parent, because all of us will always remember the years spent with such an amazing program. Thank you.